لبيك يا مغدي بروحي لبيك يا بنسم جروحي لبيك يا.
As always, dear viewers, during the period of Arbaeen, I do like to explore, I do like to go around to see all the different services that the Mawqibs have to offer for the pilgrims, and inshallah serve with all the different ways of service that are going on this walk. So as we are walking around today, we saw this Mawqib that specifies in serving fresh hot bread. I've spoken to the head of the Mawqib, he's allowed us to come in, look around and perhaps serve also. So inshallah we will go in, speak to them perhaps, maybe serve alongside them and hopefully see how they make their bread. Let's go take a look.
O visitor of Imam Al-Hussein, peace be upon him, do you know that our great sin is being oblivious to asking for the reappearance?
So this is behind the scenes of where they're making the bread. You can see here they have plenty of bags of flour ready to be put into the mixer and made into dough, which is done right here by this brother. He mixes it in the machine, takes out the pieces, the right size, puts them here on the table. Now this brother, what he does is he puts sesame on the dough and then puts it ready for the second to last process, thing in the process, and that's the flattening of the dough put on this cushion, and then this uncle who's the head of the Mawqib, he puts it into the oven ready to go out to the pilgrims. So when the bread is ready, the brothers here, they check on it, they take out all the tongs, they put it on the table, and as soon as it's on the table, the pilgrims, they come, they take it and they enjoy nice warm bread. So inshallah, let's try get involved, let's try help out, gain some tawab, and hopefully we'll be considered servants of Allah Abdullah Al-Hussein.
The reappearance of Imam Al-Mahdi in Karbala under the Blessed Dome with insistence and persistence.
So one thing now, alhamdulillah, the uncle has blessed me the chance to serve alongside them in the Mawqib. Obviously I'm not a bread maker, I've got no experience or little experience from last year, so I'm just doing the simplest of things, which is putting them, the older doughs, closer for him to use, and the fresh ones will be stacked behind so they can bring them out. It's a simple job, but alhamdulillah it's an opportunity for me to serve Imam Hussein. And in all honesty, the way I see it, all service to Imam Hussein means a lot, whatever it is. People usually sometimes think, you know, I'm not gonna clean the shoes in the mosque, I'm not gonna go clean the toys, I'm not gonna clean the car park, I'm not gonna clean the door. No, everything for Imam Hussein is a great service, because the servant of Imam Hussein is actually a king. That's what it means to be a servant of Imam Hussein. So whatever you've been asked to do, whatever you can offer, no matter how big, no matter how small, you must offer this thing, because it all goes to Aba Abdullah Al-Hussein. And alhamdulillah, I've been blessed to be able to serve here and gain some, you know, experience in bread making also. And earlier I tried some of their bread. It is truly the best bread I've tried, because it is made in the name of Imam Al-Hussein. And you can feel the love that's been put into the work, into making the bread. You can imagine, this uncle has spent his whole life making bread, and he gives up 2-3 weeks of his time to come and serve the pilgrims, making no money, buying all the equipment himself, all the ingredients himself, doing all this just to serve the pilgrims of Imam Hussein. زين حجينا انتم صار لكم كم سنه تخدمون على طريق النجف؟
تقريبا هسه صار لنا ست سنين.
So the uncle's saying that he's been serving on the road to Karbala, the Najaf Karbala road, for around 6 years now. 6 years he comes here to serve the pilgrims of Imam Hussein. Then into شنو اللي دفعكم تجون تخدمون زوار الحسين؟ يعني تعرفون اهلكم؟ تصرفون أموالكم تعبكم هالجهد شنو اللي يدفعكم؟
والله يا حب الإمام الحسين سلام الله عليه أولا اللي ضحى بحياته وبعائلته على موتنا إحنا يعني على موت الجيل الجاي المستقبل من أجل الإسلام بعد نحب نخدم الزوار اللي طريقهم بعيد جاي يجون مشي نوفر لهم المبيت نوفر لهم الطعام والشراب
مبيت هم عندكم وشراب
مبيت عندنا بس بهاي المنطقة وهنا عندنا الجماعة كلهم
بلي So he's saying not only do they serve bread But they also have a rest area, sleeping area for pilgrims to come and sleep in. And he's saying the reason we serve Imam Al-Hussein, the pilgrims of Imam Al-Hussein, because Imam Al-Hussein sacrificed everything for us. He sacrificed everything for the following generations to be able to, you know, to show their love to him. So the people who are coming to Imam Al-Hussein, they're all showing their love to him. They're all appreciating his sacrifice. So in honor of Imam Al-Hussein's sacrifice, they are serving the guests and the lovers of Imam Al-Hussein, which is the greatest thing, I think. So alhamdulillah, I mean, these people understand the values of Imam Al-Hussein, they understand the sacrifices of Imam Al-Hussein. And inshallah, they can continue to serve for the rest of their lives, and we can continue to serve alongside them, inshallah.